Bill, I appreciate what you're trying to do, and I respect your journey that you've been on, and I just think there are a lot of issues around it. I want to bring you in, Craig, in terms of this ethical dilemma. Let's say it does work for people who can afford it. Then what?
We have to rethink what it means to live a normal human lifespan, right? If we're suddenly living twice as long or an extra 50 years, we have to start thinking about overpopulation in a more real way. We've got to think about restricting the number of new births to weigh out death. I mean, there will still be death, right? There will be accidents. There will be causes of death, infectious disease, things that we can't necessarily control. Would you want to have the same job for 120 years? Or do we have people going back to school and retraining for new things?
And do we halt aging at age 16 or 25 or 45 or 65? Like, and I want to ask you, Bill, because how do you, this concept of reversing or stopping aging, do we all just end up being 25 running around and we're hanging out with our kids, you know, drinking beer?
people aren't aware of, like, if people spend as much time in hospices and nursing homes and assisted living homes as I have, people would be more aware of the fact that the real problems exist now. Nobody in 200 years from now is going to say, let's ban the cure for aging because it's causing all kinds of problems. The problems are now. There's a lot of very depressed, unhappy people in these homes who can't take care of themselves. And we just don't know about it because they're all locked up in these houses.
They're not locked up. These are people choosing to have a meaningful, beautiful way to finish the last stage of their life. These are, you know, it's not a question of, look, I appreciate that you are a visionary. I appreciate that you are trying to improve human lives. That's wonderful. My question is how you're going about doing it.
They are locked up. I've been in enough of these places. No, they can't get out. But the safety, there was an FDA-approved study where actually people had immune responses and actually got sick and almost died. And there's been some clinical studies with gene therapy, FDA-approved, where people did die. But I've looked at these studies. The people that were involved in these studies, the scientists and medical doctors, actually did some pretty dumb things. I am in disbelief that some of these things, even though they're FDA approved, were done by dumb errors and stuff. I've made certain that the study that Labella Gene Therapeutics is doing is covering every possible angle to ensure the safety. That's the number one most important thing is safety. And nobody's going to get sick or die on my watch.
And to finish this off on a really light note, if you two had to pick an age at which to just arrest aging, what would be the age you would stay at?
I feel like right around 30, because I felt like I had enough experiences.
And physically, you still feel...
Physically, I still felt good, but I had some experience and some wisdom. I think that was a pretty...
Late 20s, 30s.
Yeah. And I think it's an interesting conversation for people to have in their own mind. But just I would say probably mid-20s, because it's before things started to hurt.
Any extension of life could be cool with all that... that added experience and knowledge.
If nothing else, this shows the world how much we are learning about genetics and how everything plays such a huge role. We've learned so much more than when we were in medical school, for instance. I want to thank Bill and Craig so much for being here, offering your opinions.
Really interesting.